We have an angel with us who has been teaching for the last 40 years. But at the time of the 10th standard boards, sometimes before that, sometimes a little after that, there is one buzzword going around called aptitude tests. And some people have, many students have written in to me when we publicized this series about aptitude tests. What are these aptitude tests and are they really necessary?
There was a time when in India, people used to go after 10th PUC, after PUC degree, after degree post graduation, and then later apply, no reply. It was because they have chosen the careers without finding what exactly is their aptitude. But slowly time is changing, and now people have found out, like foreign countries, right at the early stage, you find out your aptitudes in 10th standard, whether you are suited for science, commerce, arts, in PUC, if it is science, whether you are good for medicine, engineering, other courses. If you are taking commerce, should you go for company secretary, chartered accountant, or BCom, BBA, and so on. For this, only just talking no use. You have to conduct what are your inherent strength skill test. So these skill tests conducted by a trained career counselor is called aptitude test. These tests are conducted all over India, even in Mangalore. Prajna Counseling Center, you might have heard about Roshni, St. Agnes, St. Aloysius, wherever there are PG centers for psychology. So the HODs and other lecturers conduct these tests. They're charging about 500 to 1,000 rupees for 3 hours. But they're worth because the tests are conducted in such a way, whatever inherent strength you have, all these are exposed. And later with the parents and the child, there is a talk about half an hour, 1 hour. What are your strengths? You cannot simply say, I want to become a doctor. There are many other careers possible. So they'll tell you what are the real career, your strengths. So these aptitude tests are conducted at 10th standard level, at PUC level to find out your inherent strengths. I feel it is a must, whether you are in a village or in a city, if you do these tests, you really find out what exactly is suited for you.
Just one follow-up question on that, Professor. Suppose I want to be a doctor. That's my personal desire. But the aptitude test that I take and the career counseling that I undergo tells me that I'm not suited to become a doctor, then what happens to me? What is my future? What is my psychological state? And how do I go forward?
Yeah, it's a very good question. There are many, many times where our ambitions, dreams are so many, but they really don't come true. Either you don't have money or you don't have enough marks for that. That's why a career should depend mainly on not only aptitude, but also employability and family background. Because many a time, the one particular career you might be having in mind, but you may not be able to get, then you also have to think about the others, especially employability. There are many, many engineers today who are unemployed. There are many graduates, postgraduates, like MBA or MA, MSc who are unemployed. That's why you have to also think about some 2-3 careers right from SSLC. Okay, what if I don't get this, what next, instead of getting dejected and committing suicide, and so many people have done that who didn't get medicine or IITs and so on. You should have at least 2-3 careers in mind, and if not one, take the other one, take the next one, take the next one, and so on. But while taking, you should be very careful that you have to have aptitude also, at the same time, employability also.